Right, scalpel. Are you looking at me, guy?
We're losing adrenaline now.
You'll never amount to anything, Pat.
Everybody clear. You scum.
We've lost him.
It takes a lot to stir my regions, but tonight I am stirring, for we begin the Gamesmaster annual football tournament, an event that makes the FA Cup look like some kick around in an unfashionable public park. This week also sees the release of Killer Instinct on the Super NES. We'll take a look at that version later on, but for now we'll stick like batter to the superior arcade version for our first event, which we call King Combo. The latest weapon in the beat-em-up player's arsenal is the combo, a well-tough series of kicks and punches executed in quick succession against the other bloke. It's a skill remembering the move sequence in split-second time and required type situation. Killer Instinct is Mr. Undisputed leader of the field with some of the most complex and devastating moves around. The game also features combo breakers, which allow you to quite literally interrupt your opponent's combo onslaughts, as well as unleashing the impressive shadow moves. But the jewel in the crown of Killer Instinct has to be the Ultra Combo, a fantastically huge series of blows activated automatically at the end of a bout by pressing lots of buttons. It requires a level of skill that only Frank Best Player can achieve. We're hoping to crown King Combo today. So please welcome three young men who regularly parade down the high street wearing T-shirts saying, I'm fantastic at combos and then some. Rory Reid, David Flood and Garlic Toe. Hello, Rory. Hello, David. Welcome to the show, Garlic. OK, just for a change, we're going to talk about ladies here. Rory, you've got a girlfriend just now, don't you?
Yeah, I do.
And your friends don't, your mates don't know who she is, is that
true?
No,
I don't think so.
Okay, so we won't give that away or anything. Like. So what is Anna like? Is she attractive?
Yeah, I guess so, I suppose.
Nice girl?
Yeah, she's all right.
Intelligent?
Yeah.
What's she doing with you then?
Don't know, sucker.
All right. David, now, you've had another kind of unhappy lady experience, kind of, to do with video games.
Yeah. And I got beaten by a girl in the Blockbuster video.
How old was this girl?
I don't know, about 12 or so.
About being by a 12-year-old girl. I must say, we're not being sexist here. Of course, girls can be equally as good at video games as boys. I mean, they're not, but they could be. Right, finally, Garlic, have you got a girlfriend?
No.
No. What happened to your last one then?
Don't know, it just didn't work out.
What's your record then for total amount of combos?
48 hits with Orchid.
48 with Orchid, David?
48.
48 as well with Orchid, Rory?
47 with Orchid.
47 with Orchid, so you're slightly behind
slightly
these guys.
Slightly behind, but it depends on the day, you know.
That's right, under pressure. They could capitulate, I think is a very long word for it. Okay, if you'd like to move over to the machine then and get ready to play, I'll go up to the commentary box.
The idea here is brutally simple. Whoever manages to pull off the combo with the highest number of moves will earn the golden joystick. Each contestant has one bout in which to prove their combo credentials.
And who better to help us count the combos than our own arcade beat-em-up expert, Derek Lynch from Funland. Derek, they've all chosen Orchid as their character. Why is that?
Well, Orchid can pull off the largest combos.
Right, nothing to do with the fact she is the most attractive character in a top outfit as well. What's the most amount of combos you've ever seen?
48. 48 combos.
And was that at Funland?
That's right, done by Garlic Toe.
Oh, so Garlic actually did that
in front
of your very eyes.
That's 48. Right, and he's here today. Yeah.
That's a fantastic amount. Well, basically what's going to happen is each competitor is going to have one bout each to try and put off the largest ultra combo they can. Rory's up first. Best of luck, Rory. Start your challenge. So Rory is playing Orchid on the left of the screen. That's the girl in the kind of snazzy green outfit. She's just into a tiger there. Look at Riptor's energy bar at the top right-hand corner. That's the computer there. When that starts to flash, then Orchid can go into the ultra combo. Derek, what's happening here, man?
Well, Rory's trying to pull off a combo breaker, which will give him an extra 7 hits at the end. He can do it.
OK, he's done that. He's managed to take the first part of this bout. Now he's got him trapped in the corner here, Derek. Okay.
Combo breaker. Riptor's actually given a lot of trouble. Into a Puma. Oh, he's trying something there. No.
And awesome, that's only eight hits. We went a lot more than that though, Derek, don't we?
Definitely, definitely. So he's going to try, I think he's going to try and back off.
He actually got beaten there, Rory got beaten for that second there. Okay, now here it comes. We're looking for this big combo starting now, okay, Derek.
Laser slashes, kick flip, helicopter, laser slashes, kick flip. He started his ultra activator.
This is looking good, Derek. Up in the air.
Will he get fireball in? Missed the fireball.
Missed the fireball. 41 hit combo throw. Amazing from Rory there. Rory, make way for David. While he does that, we'll take a look at Rory's replay here, Derek, and you can tell me exactly where he missed those vital hits.
Yeah, the mistake Rory made, he missed out on his combo breaker, so that's cost him an extra two hits.
So he's down to 46 five, already.
Exactly, and then he started too close, started his combo too close, and plus he missed a fireball at the end. So altogether, that's a total of seven hits he's missed out on, potentially.
Okay then, best of luck, David, 41 to beat. Off you go. Off goes David again to Rocket. This time the computer's playing Saber Wolf. Yeah, but the same deal goes with the energy bar. When Saber Wolf's one flashes, then he can go into the ultra combo. A good start though from David here,
That's
Derek.
Right. Lots of good combos in there. Blaster.
Some top luminous cougar action there as well again.
So David himself will be trying to do combo break as well.
Now, what exactly is the combo breaker?
Well, when the computer is doing a combo on you, you can do a special move and stop the actual chain of events.
And that's your combo breaker.
That's right.
We warmed up there with a little 16-hit combo. Now, here we are. We're going into it now, Derek.
Only killer 13 hits.
But he's still got some time left.
Laser slashes. More laser slashes. He's gone into his ultra.
He's got him in the corner here. This is looking great here. Fireballs. Just the one, but it did hit, and that's a 43-hit combo there. So David goes into the lead. Let's take a look at his replay, Derek. Where did David go wrong?
Well, he missed his combo breaker once again, just like Rory, and that's cost him another two hits, but he mistimed his combos with the kickflip here, and as a result, that cost him an extra five.
I'm glad you spotted that, Derek, because it was going far, far too fast for me.
It's rapid.
So 43, though, David takes the lead. Now it's Garlock's turn. Garlock, 43 to beat. Best of luck. Off you go.
Ready.
Garlock is playing against Thunder, this time the kind of red Indian with the tragically unhit Mohican.
That's the breaker. That's right, he got his combo breaker in.
So he's going to be able to do three fireballs at the end. So a possible 48 maximum here.
Shadow move in there. He's doing some defensive jumps. Okay, starts with a kickflip, lasers. Another shadow move.
It's amazing there.
King, 11 hits. Not too bad there.
So is that a case now of just getting into the right position to start off
the
combo?
That's right, trying to get the right position, the right distance to start his combo. He's going to make some distance there for himself. Fireball.
Give him back a bit. We could be getting there soon. We're just waiting for that bar to turn as well.
Vicious head
top head for action. From Thunder now, it's flashing now. We can see it soon. He's got to get the exactly right distance away to start this.
He's doing his jumps to try and get the right distance. Okay,
keep this bait here.
Flaming Tomahawk's coming in there.
He's just trying to get in the right position. Right. He can get the 48 maximum, though. It's just all about timing now at this
timing.
Point.
And distance. Okay, right.
Here we go.
Helicopter, kickflip, laser slashes. Helicopter, laser slashes, kickflip.
This is looking great.
He's right into the ultra activator.
He's all over him. He's up there. He's going to get the three fireballs.
One, two, three.
Three fireballs. What's this? It's a 46-hit combo. Astonishing there by Garland. But we didn't quite get the maximum, Derek, so where did he miss the other two? Let's have a look.
Okay. What happened here is hit with the helicopter hit twice, when it should have been just one hit.
Right, now why was that?
The computer moved in, actually, so it's not due to lack of skill.
Right, it's the computer doing it. It's quite strange that you actually have to hit them less in order to get the full combo.
That's right.
But it's all about timing.
Exactly.
Although after then, Derek, I mean, he did not put a foot wrong. Look at this top Indian kicking head in action here. I thought you could have missed him. Is this difficult to pull off the three fireballs?
It is. You've got to time it perfectly as the opponent is falling from the sky.
That's
and
right,
the three fireballs straight in there.
Straight on the
and
bottom.
That's it.
I think and that is it. A fantastic 46-hit combo. It means Garlock is the winner. Listen, commiserations there, Rory. You got a 41-hit combo against...
Riptor.
So why couldn't you squeeze that extra few
The joystick miles? Wasn't functioning. I couldn't quite pull off the last move to link it to the Ultra.
That is pathetic.
No, it's not.
You can't just blame machinery. This is a prime piece of arcade technology here. You can be sued by these guys for saying that. Do you know that, Rory?
You must have broke.
I'll start saving up your money now. Your backside is theirs in the courts. David, all right, don't complain anymore, Rory. David, right, you got 43 against Saberwolf.
Yeah.
What went wrong with you?
I started the combo off wrong. I started it wrong.
So how did you, what should you have done then?
I was meant to only one hit right from the beginning move, but it, three times.
So it's quite complicated, really.
Yeah.
Isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, garlic. What can I say? 46 at combo. You did say, though, you could get a 48. In fact, Derek backed that up. Why couldn't you get 48 tonight?
Oh, I tried to hit him once, like David said, but my one hit three times again, like he said.
So missed time to start again?
Yeah.
So are you gutted, then, that you didn't get the 48?
Yep.
Well, despondent perfectionist that you are, Garlic. It was certainly good enough for us today. And that ripping 46 at combo means the Games Master golden joystick goes to Garlic. If you could pull off a better combo than these gentlemen, drop us a line. The address will appear as if by magic at the end of the show. If you can't, then get a girlfriend. That can be just as much fun. Now, let's see if the Super NES conversion of Killer Instinct is similarly fantastic or simply trousers as we go over to Rick and Dave.
Instinct, I'm telling you, is the best beat 'em up I have played this year. Forget platforms like the Saturn or the PlayStation. This is on the SNES, and it's fantastic.
Killer Instinct is awesome. Nintendo can finally lay the ghost of Street Fighter 2 to rest. It is incredible. It's 20-hit combos. It's ultra combos. It's got everything, and the SNES version loses nothing in translation.
There is still the challenge in mastering all the combo moves. There are all the special moves. There are the finishing moves. It's got so much depth to it that it makes games like Mortal Kombat, Toshinden, and even Virtua Fighter look very pale indeed.
In the Park is a new adventure released this week. It stars ex-Baywatch actress Erika Eleniak, who I have a lot of respect for because she has a great mind and is dangerously witty. The action takes place in Skyview, an aging amusement park threatened with closure unless you, the player bloke, can find the missing deed that proves ownership.
My ruling is final. You've got until 10 o'clock tomorrow morning to present evidence showing ownership.
Jimmy Scumbag Bloke has nicked the deed, and it's up to you to uncover the murky deed surrounding its theft.
Black man, a touch of arson, maybe even murder.
To do this, you'll need to get clues from the park's various characters and endure the usual standards of CD-ROM acting.
Hey there, glad to see you.
Welcome to the Street of Dreams.
Howdy!
Just be careful, this place is filled with angry people.
Hey man, what are you doing over here this late at night?
Shut up. These temperamental types will only talk turkey if you play their increasingly difficult games. Jerks.
Not as easy as it looked, huh?
Helping you along the way are twin sisters Jamie and Jenny, both played by Erika. Jamie's rather sweet.
Look, I know this isn't your problem, but at least you can still get into the park.
Whereas Jenny's a pin in the posterior.
Some people say I'm greedy. Well, maybe so, but mostly I'm a realist. And I'm gonna get what's mine.
Get with the plot, lady. Panic in the Park boasts over 200 possible outcomes, more than 30 characters, and a large field full of puzzles and games. If that's not enough for you, there's always Erika.
So what's the deal? In or out?
Yes, please. The whole of heaven is going officially football bonkers in preparation for the first round of the Games Master Football Tournament, and our two footballing celebs, Dean Holdsworth and David Kerslake, are quite literally waiting to come on after the break. I hope your break was as moist as mine. If not, then please feel free to complain to the person sitting on your right. Now, football is about the greatest thing this planet has to offer, and it's no tiny wee surprise that there has been 7 billion computer game versions to date. We'll kick off our championships with a quick look at the latest and greatest. This year's crop of new footy games should be the best yet, but looking down on all the ankle-biting young whippersnapper pretenders is a spanky new 3D version of FIFA Soccer. FIFA 96 for the PC and next-generation consoles, featuring commentary by Mr. Much Better Than Barry Davis, John Watson.
Yikes.
Hughes.
Shot by Hughes. That's it. The final whistle's gone.
It's a bit like the 3DO version. The players move smoothly, and it actually looks like a real football game. Trouble is, a lot of it gets a bit pixely at times. But this is probably the best FIFA game you're going to find. It plays fantastically, and if you put up with the pixels, you're going to enjoy it.
FIFA games have generally been criticised for being far too linear. People have talked about the fact that the computer controls the players more than you actually do. This one doesn't do that. The players themselves also have their own attributes. Each player from every team around the world will play just like the player in real life.
And the nice thing is the John Motson commentary actually uses all the players' names from all the teams around the world, so it really is like watching an actual football match.
Interception, right. Arsenal.
Take the lead!
The 16-bit FIFA 96, also due in November, doesn't have commentary or front-seat camera work, but does feature more leagues and playing tactics, so there. FIFA's big rival on the PC and 32-bit consoles comes in the form of actual soccer.
Oh, so close there. Just wide of the post.
Top football blokes had some motions, which were sampled to create the game's realistic animation. Unfortunately, so was Barry Davis.
Embiid! Keeper must have his lucky gloves on today, and it's gone in off the post.
If you zoom in on a game like FIFA, you'll notice that the players turn into Lego brick men. But on actual soccer, all that motion-grabbing technology has really paid off because the players hold their form. The realism is superb, but does this make it a better game?
Yes, it does make for a better game. FIFA has had its day, and actual soccer has come to take the crown. The players themselves are far more controlled, and it just moves so much more like an arcade game rather than FIFA's sluggishness.
You know that? Chance on that? Deschamps.
Deep.
Offside!
On the 16-bit side, there's another update in the form of International Superstar Soccer Deluxe, boasting new in-game additions like dribbling on the ball and a handy overhead flick. Turning to the PlayStation, if you can bear to wait 6 months until you buy a footy game, then you'll have the choice of Power Sports Soccer from the makers of Wipeout. But if your football game corks need to be popped now, the only option is Japanese import Winning 11, to be released over here next month under the title Goalstorm. It's a veritable top graphics and fantastic footy gameplay action type situation. And indeed, we have plucked Winning 11 from this bunch, gave it a loving rub and said, can we use your game for the first two rounds of our tourney, please, mister? So, welcome our first two semi-finalists in a Wimbledon v Tottenham London derby type situation, Dean Holdsworth and David Kerslake.
Nice to come along, David. Right now, Dean, I'm going to come right out and say you are a fantastically attractive young man. You've done a lot of modelling. What do the rest of the Wimbledon team think about that?
Well, obviously, you know, when I do the modelling, I put myself up for a bit of stick and I get my fair share of it as well.
Would you say your teammates are hideously ugly in comparison?
I wouldn't say that. You can say that.
No, I can say that because I'm safe here. They can't actually jump inside the telly. Not even Vinny, he can even do that. Right, David, what kind of game are we going to see from you tonight then?
Fast attacking, plenty of goals hopefully. Should be good fun, yeah.
Yeah, sounds very confident. That's good. Well, we'll see how that turns out. While David and Dean have their pre-match chicken and beans, we're going to go over to Games Master for some tips on how to get that onion in the bag.
The most effective way to score is by running the ball down the wings and crossing it to a player in front of the goal who should whack it in the net without further ado. Another useful tactic is to use the after-touch function. Just after you've shot the ball, wait until it's near the keeper, then quickly use aftertouch to give it that final unexpected impetus. Players should beware of using a sliding tackle to bring down an opponent, since this will almost always result in a foul. Instead, try to get in front of the player before you put the boot in.
So Dean Holdsworth and David Kerslake are just about to kick off. Joining me in the dugout is PC Review's Rick Henderson. Hello, Rick.
Hello, Dominic.
Rick, that was a nice little kind of movement. Yeah, your voice is very good, especially for football.
Up and down.
It certainly was. Rick, how do you see this game going?
Well, if as long as Dean sort of like plays the Wimbledon way, tonks it upfield, looks for the big man, he'll be all right. David, based on Spurs, I think he just better score.
Right, OK, fair enough. That's quite nice and succinct, Rick. OK, best of luck, Dean. Best of luck, David. Let's go to kick off.
So Dean Holdsworth is in the red, playing the Atlas team from left to right. And David Kerslake is in the yellow, playing from right to left, and he is Jeff United.
And already you can see Dean has had a shot there. It's going to be quite a shooting game, I think.
OK. Maybe the reason Dean missed there was he really thought he was playing for Spurs then. But the Chris Armstrong's there in front of goals.
He bottled it then, didn't he?
OK, and here comes David again.
And he's through, surely.
Oh,
there's nobody else. There's no landmine. That was surely all the way then. He caught it beautifully on the volley.
It's a very feeble throw out there from Dean's keeper.
But the defence has done very well. He skips over one challenge after another.
Not much longer left to go until half-time.
No, we're not. We're looking for last break just before half-time. This is the best time to score.
The keeper's a bit.
He could have taken it round him, but the keeper just saw it at the last second.
He was just hanging back there.
Showed him too much of the ball.
Okay, approaching half time. Just a couple of seconds to go. 4 seconds to go. This is going to be the last effort of the game, but David's defence should safely pick this up. That's it. The whistle goes half time. It's 0-0. Great, we've had no goals so far then. What would you recommend to Dean and David?
Shoot from anywhere on the pitch, but mainly shoot from the edge of the area. Right. Over to one corner, shoot across the goalkeeper.
Okay.
Best way to score.
All right, let's kick off the second half. Let's go back to the action. Okay, so now David is still in the yellow, but he's playing from left to right now. And Dean is in the red, playing from right to left. Another early shot there.
Dean started as he sort of left the last half, just going from anywhere. Just hitting it from his own penalty area, trying to hit the crossbar and maybe get a deflection or something.
Oh, that's a lovely
David's got in, and he's in the...
He runs away.
Running away from the ball is not the best tactic. what they have to remember is you can also put aftertouch on the ball by pressing the top buttons, and they should try and curl it around the goalkeeper.
To give them more of a chance.
Generally, you need the ball to try and do that.
Still no goals, a lot of crunching tackles. The tempo's getting a bit
afraid. Yeah, they're getting a bit afraid. They're getting a bit nervous, I think. One of them needs a goal now to really
electrify. The keeper's missed,
surely! Dean Holdsworth has hit it across the goalkeeper, just as I said he should.
The
goalkeeper actually, to be honest.
There,
he was at fault, but that was a superb angle shot.
Superb goal from Dean Holdsworth, 1-0. And can David come back? He doesn't have a lot of time left for it. What would you do if you were in David's shoes?
Tonk it now. Just go for it every opportunity you get.
He's got to get it back now, David, if he's going to have any hope of equalising.
He's going to hoof it up.
Hoofs it forward.
One last shot.
It's a final shot.
Maybe if he'd put the aftertouch on it, it would have gone in.
But the aftertouch was not forthcoming. And he
he's got another go. He's up.
Chance. It's through into space.
No, that's it.
The referee blows his whistle. The final result is Dean Holdsworth 1, David Kerslake 0.
Bad luck, David. Well played, Dean.
Right, David, the start of the game, you were piling on the pressure. Why couldn't you convert it into goals?
A bit disappointed in me front two, actually, but I would have thought these goalkeeper gets the MO then.
Yeah, that goalkeeper, but your goalkeeper then, was he at fault for that goal?
Not too much, but he should have done better, perhaps.
If I have said, Dean, talk us through that goal then. How did you do it?
Well, it's a little bit of composure and a bit of confidence, obviously. Goalkeeper come out, went around him, and they just started it away in a nice angle.
And next week we've got Phil Babb and Graham Lasso playing another semi-final. Who would you rather meet in the final?
I'd rather meet Graham Lasso. I think Babb is a bit useful.
All right, well, we'll find out about that then next week, who's going to make that. But thank you very much indeed, David Kerslake and Dean Holdsworth. As I've said, the second semi-final of the Games Master Football Tournament next week, Graham Lasso against Phil Babb, a clash of defensive titans. Until then, remember, life is a bit like playing football. If you've got a mazy dribble, you will go far. Bye-bye.